inner world of RTX and 7 nanometer Navi and are now RTX Super. Is the RX 580 still alive? Well, MSI seems to think so. In this week's episode of Something Amazing, we're going to be taking a look again at the RX 580 and ask the question, is it still a viable option in the fourth quarter of 2019? And how good is it when it comes to 1440p gaming? Let's get into it. Well, around the beginning of November, there was an article that came out that said that MSI is going to be remaking the RX 580 and launching a Armor version 2 of the GPU. And that got us thinking, like, why would they do that? I thought the RX 580 would be dead by now. It's been serving us well. I actually have the ASUS Strix gaming OC RX 580 that's been in my rig for quite some time now, and I find it as a good, it's a good balance between obviously the editing workflow that we do and gaming. During the second half of this year, there was a lot of emphasis, I don't know, we've been bombarded basically, a lot of hype around gaming monitors, more specifically geared towards 144Hz gaming monitors. If you missed it on our channel, we actually had recently also purchased the Dell gaming monitor that you see behind me. And the new norm seems to be the 27-inch gaming monitors, and more specifically 1440p gaming. So it got us thinking, why would MSI want to launch another RX 580? And how good is the RX 580 in 1440p gaming? So we basically ran a few small tests, real-world gaming tests obviously. If you'd like to see the benchmarks, etc., we did cover this in another video and I'll link it in the description box down below, and it should pop up somewhere on the top here if you'd like to check that video out, where we obviously went into Cinebench scores, Firestrike, etc., etc. Just as a reference, our unit here for the testing, I ran it at the stock clock speeds on our Ryzen 2700, which is at 3.2 gigahertz. On the ASUS Strix graphics card that we have in here, it has a factory overclock of 1380 megahertz with a memory clock of 8000 megahertz. So the first game obviously I wanted to test is one that most people play, and most people that do get 1440p 144Hz monitors is Counter-Strike. So when running Counter-Strike at 1440p, on average on the Dust map, which is the most famous map that's been there for a very long time, we saw an average of 179 FPS with a maximum of 258 FPS. We did overclock this GPU in a previous episode, and I did run that overclock settings again. Basically we pushed the boost clock up to 1480 MHz, and we boosted the memory clock speed up to 9000 MHz, and in those tests we got very, very good results at 1440p of an average FPS of 228 frames per second with a maximum of 240 frames per second and a minimum only of 196 frames per second. Obviously not everybody wants to do 1440p gaming. However, just to touch on something, if you do get a 27-inch monitor, it's much better to go 1440p, and the reason behind it is you can play games at full HD, but the problem is the pixel density is much lower than 1440p, and in games the images won't be as sharp, and when you look at images and icons, etc., and pictures on your desktop, they usually have jagged edges and they're not as sharp and not as clear, and that's due to the lower pixel density. So if you go 27-inch, that you would want a 1440p monitor at least. When running CS Counter-Strike at full HD, we saw an average of 205 frames per second with a maximum of 292. So basically, the RX 580 is still, if you're running at 144 hertz, you're gonna be running a FPS more than that. And it's going, if you run AMD FreeSync, that's on this monitor, and this is, monitor is also G-Sync capable, you're gonna get that good adaptive sync technology, and you're gonna have an extremely smooth playback of your games, and obviously reduced input lag, which does improves your performance in game. The next game that we tested out is obviously something that most people would say, no, but you need very, very good hardware. You need at least a RTX 2080 to run this, and that's PUBG. Everybody knows the demands of PUBG are quite heavy. You need generally a very strong system to run PUBG. But when we fired up PUBG, I've been running PUBG on this now on 4040p for some time, and let me tell you something, it's beautiful. Sorry, I forgot to mention, on the Counter-Strike, we ran all the settings at maximum, and in PUBG, we ran all settings at high. And on PUBG, on the Vikendi map, been playing it for like the last week and a half, and whenever I play the Vikendi map, we got an average of 79 frames per second with the maximum of 94 frames per second. On Muruma, I saw an average of 75 frames per second, and on Erangel, an average of 78 frames per second with a maximum of 90 frames per second. So on average, we got about 78, 79 frames per second with a maximum of 94 frames per second. And yes, it's lower than your 144 hertz, but if you're running a 60 hertz 4040p monitor, or you're running the adaptive sync technology, you won't get that screen tearing, and it smoothens out the gameplay and the picture adequately. You don't even notice any stuttering, you don't see any motion blur, and that's where the adaptive sync technology really comes in, really shines. So the question is, should you get an RX 580? Like, let's just be honest, right? We in this week of Black Friday, there's a lot of GPUs that are out there on the market now for sale, with some great savings. Let's not be honest, but I'm of that old school thinking. I find it hard to say that one component in my system can cost the rest more than the rest of my system. If you look at, for example, your high-end RTX 2080 Ti cards, it just doesn't make sense to me. And let's be honest, in South Africa, we're going through a tough economic times now. The cost of living, petrol, food is at all-time high. And I was listening on the radio the other day, they said that consumer purchasing, stand to be corrected, but they said it's down by 13%, and people are really feeling the pinch. And especially in these times, to go and fork out that amount of cash on a high-end GPU just doesn't make sense. So why go for an RX 580? The performance gains for what you pay for this card is really, there's nothing out there that can compare to it. These cards, I've seen them sell secondhand for as low as 1,000 rand, 1,500 rand. And these Strix gaming OC cards, I've seen them sell on the forums locally secondhand for around 2,000, 2,500, sometimes 3,000 rand, depending on how much of a warranty is left on the card. So these cards are still being sold with warranties. And it really, you should really ask yourself the question, you know, should I go and spend 25,000 rand on a top end, high end card, or 2,500 rand on a good Strix RX 580, for example, with a decent cooler on it? I'm sure you can use the extra money to upgrade another component in a system that you may be building, for example, investing in a proper gaming monitor. Because, like, what's the point of having a RX 2080 Ti, but you're running it on a 60Hz full HD monitor? It doesn't make sense. And obviously, we're going now into the Christmas season. You know, it would be good to have some extra cash, obviously, for gifts for loved ones, for yourself, and also to have a break after working hard the entire year. So just something to think about. It's something that popped a question in our minds, and we hope this video helped in some way to make a decision on what GPU you should get, especially if you're just building a new desktop, or you're looking to upgrade from an older GPU that you may have had in your system. The RX 580 comes in at an amazing price point right now, and still has decent performance that you won't be utterly disappointed. Obviously, there's a lot of the newer GPUs is going to smash the results of this card in particular, but for what you're paying for it, it's next to nothing. A night out is going to cost you more than that. Anyway, we hope you guys enjoyed this video. As always, remember to subscribe. If you found this video informative and you liked it, please share, and also please comment down in the comment section down below. And yeah, we'll catch you in the next one. Cheers, bye.